What's going on, everybody? Now, today is a very special day because today is the day when I tell y'all the story about when me, Abdul, Nick, Braun, Nugget went to the beach in Ocean City, went to the nightclub, H2O, got some bitches, not really though, and then we went to the boardwalk and we recorded very minimal. It was supposed to be a vlog, but I didn't record much because I'm on vacation. I don't want to have my camera in everybody's face because that's cuntish, and I don't like to be cuntish, okay, everybody? So...
Put that in.
What?
Can't put that shit in.
I'm gonna do it anyway. I don't give a fuck. So, start off this story. The drive there wasn't too bad, okay? The drive was, it was a little long. We just sat there, listened to music, didn't really do much, talked a lot of shit. When we got there, though, it was a whole different story. Shit got rowdy almost instantly.
Young, dumb, and bro. We're halfway to Ocean City. What's your opinion?
Let's go! Yo, we finally made it to the motherfucking hotel. 3 hours. Abdul's here. Nugs apparently knows the owner. I thought it was bullshit, but he actually does.
How?
You thought it was bullshit?
Yeah.
I thought it was bullshit too, but apparently it's not. He's gonna go talk to the guy. We made it, everybody. Look at our hotel. Our motel. This shit is tough. Guys, his door open. We're on him.
Shout out to my guy in the office, you know, real cool guy.
Yo. Nugs got this room for us. He paid for the whole thing. He said it'd be free, so he's such a sweetie.
My sugar daddy.
He really is. Look at this bitch. All paid by yours truly, OC.
Yo, the coffee.
Yo, what the fuck?
The
but I'm putting you.
You can put me in the closet. Don't put that.
I'm putting you. No.
Oh my god. I thought someone broke.
Oh. Oh. So after getting really rowdy and spanking each other quite a lot, we decided that we were hungry as hell. After that 3 hour drive and the quite inconvenience of spanking, we needed something to munch on. So we decided on pizza.
I'm in the shower. She back.
Mm-hmm. Breeze Bruder. Please open.
Come on, daddy.
Please.
I want to see that vanilla.
Shut up. Please, Nugget. Let me in. Please.
What's up, man?
You're so sexy for the camera. We in OC. Then we decided to head to the boardwalk, which, by the way, the driest place in the fucking world. I thought OC was supposed to be lit. Nugget's talking about this place like it's the holy land of lit. That was corny as fuck. I'm sorry. He was talking about this place like it's some holy grail of pussy and alcohol, and it was nothing. All right, y'all. So, we went to the boardwalk, right? Nugget was telling us it's gonna be mad fun, mad bitches. It's gonna be all the good shit here. There was absolutely nothing. It was a complete waste of time. We walked
me and Hunter Brown had a good time.
Me and Abdul got fries though.
Fat fuck.
Look at you, donut. That didn't come out, right?
Yeah.
So we're gonna tell him that it was mad fun, so he gets pissed that he didn't come.
Yeah.
That's the whole salute. That's basically what we're doing here.
And me and Hunter Brown was getting active on the boardwalk.
Yes, sir.
You guys can look at those clips.
Brown, 20 bucks. He couldn't catch that seagull. Let's see what he does. Come on.
Grab that bitch.
Grab him,
bro. I'm seeing they're gonna run. Catch it.
Yo, Reese, is that you, bro?
Catch it.
I love how Nugget decided to say that stupid shit when he's actually built like that. You fucking fat meatball fuck! Oh, I cannot hear you, bro. One more time.
Dude, when are y'all coming back? It's been like an hour.
Why you?
I don't know. It's mad fun out here, bro. There's so many broads. We went to H2O and everyone was coming out, bro. There's so many bitches. Anybody can get ass there. Yeah, I was getting snaps, ass, everything, dude. Abdul was getting active too, bro.
Me and Abdul was a VIP.
How far are you?
Like, you don't give a fuck about that shit. That's terrible. I don't think we ever told Nick that we made that joke. I'm actually pretty sure that he still thinks that we got a bunch of broads. We didn't do any of that. It was the worst shit ever. Nick, if you're watching this, you get fucking pranked, punk.
Day two.
All right, Joe, how y'all feeling? So, we brought burgers and shit to the vacation with us. And we brought this bitch, right? Remember this? Nick got some sexy seasoning.
Put that on
camera. Merv got that shit right. Yeah, look at that shit. That shit's sexy. Prime steak. Anyway, little plot twist though. Our brother wanted Chipotle because Chipotle is the best fast food on earth. So I went to get it, right? But I accidentally ordered it to a Chipotle 30 minutes away, so I had to go get that shit, because fuck, I look like missing out on Chipotle. But while I was gone, Nugget broke into a room. He fucking broke in. Yeah. So now we have a new room, but also this room has a stove, so that means you can cook shit. Which is crazy, by the way. I don't understand why I don't have a stove in our hotel room. How are we supposed to do anything? When you're in a hotel or motel, aren't you supposed to be able to like live on that shit for a day, right? Isn't that the whole idea?
I think.
So what the hell are they doing? These guys are morons. Nugget's friend didn't get us right at all. Ironic twist, though, once again, we didn't even use it. We never used it once. We cooked on the grill, and then that was it. Papa Bear came out of bed. Let's go. About time. You wasted the whole day.
Day's already over. 370 down the drain.
We're not a good group?
Nah. Wrong,
why?
Wrong group.
Wrong group, why?
We're going to the beach, baby. Right?
We're going to Hooters, too.
Yeah. Well, so I can get nothing?
It's not our fault you're broke, dude. You're having three burgers. You're good, bro.
I don't want a burger. I want cheese.
No. Whoa, what are you doing?
There's a fucking burger.
There's a lot of them.
No, there's only 10 slices and there's 10 burgers in total.
See?
Motherfucker, and you already ate one.
Asshole, there's 9. No. You're getting a cheeseless burger.
You ate one already?
Yeah.
You're getting the cheeseless one. You should have got Chipotle or Chick-fil-A with us.
Nope, too broke.
Damn. How are the burgers, Nugs?
Fucking amazing.
Oh, we should do it. What does y'all want to
do?
We should
do that TikTok.
No, let's do it right now.
Let's do it on bronze.
No, oh, he's not going to do it, though. He's going to be all pissed.
That's not fucking bronze, bro.
All right, fuck it. We should try it. Bronny, listen. We have an idea.
All right.
Listen. So Nug's upstairs doing all those pussy-ass TikToks, right? So we're going to do a TikTok with him, right? But do you know they give my money shit? Or, you know, I'm going to be all laughing if we're going to do it to him.
Alright,
man.
This nigga's
bro,
we're about to throw the fuck out of
here. He's so fucking dumb, dude. This one keep making these dumbass TikToks. Let's make a TikTok.
Just give me my money.
Yeah.
Alright, yeah, Abdul, yeah. Alright, it's my turn. Alright. Just give me my money. Yeah. See, that's tough.
Just give me my money.
Yeah. Yeah. Nugget almost ruined it.
Yeah!
Like, this is gonna be a surprise if we do it on.
Let's do it on Hunter Braun.
Okay. Alright! I love Hunter Braun so much, bro. He always falls for this stupid shit. It's my favorite. We do this to him off camera, like, probably every other time we hang out. We just prank the shit out of him. He's so susceptible to pranks. He's my favorite. I love Hunter Braun. Ronnie, I love you, baby. I love you, bro. Oh my god, dude. I know that's just corny, but I don't care, bro. It's so funny. As I'm watching these clips and narrating for y'all, I never realized how much we truly wrestle. It is un-fucking real. Oh my god, look at him.
Freeze!
No!
Oh! Get ready.
Bro.
Oh. Damn. Get ready. Don't break his out.
They
would chill here for an hour.
They're
gonna
kill him,
dude.
Oh shit, fuck him, man. Oh.
Wrestle, please, our.
No, no.
No, fucking
it's so fluid. Oh my.
Hey, you're close. Oh shit.
I'm back, boy.
Put him to sleep. Don't worry, everybody. My ass was out, but I still got the job done. All right, so Abdul was kind enough to do a little addition to the narrating, so I'm just gonna let him explain this little part we're about to do next.
Say we chill here for an hour, then go to the beach at 4, then chill there till 6, come back, get ready, go, and then go to the thing.
You're gay!
Yeah, Abdul! So the wind was out of control, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, I couldn't even believe it. I mean, just take a listen. So we get to the beach, and right when we try to get in the water, the lifeguards are telling us, hey, no swimming. I didn't know whether it was because of a shark, whether it was because of any whatever, but she said no swimming. So, we couldn't do that, so we immediately got bored as hell. We had to figure out what to do. Look at me and Abs, dude, we in this bitch. We found this community umbrella and shit, we got the ocean. But apparently, our theory is there's either a shark or the waves are just too large.
It's a bird, nigga.
Oh! What we found, Nugget? Look! Look, Bass, come here! No!
And then you pull it out, smack that ass, go back in.
You are so fucking bored, aren't you? Yes.
I mean, you're pretty good at it.
Bro, go pull a fat girl.
No. Say sorry.
So being bored, we had to figure out something to do. So we decided that I was going to bury myself. And with doing that, we had to dig a pretty large hole. Now the hole is ready, ladies and gentlemen. Now we just gotta see if a big brother can fit in that hole. So I just remembered, and I was thinking about it a little bit here, making this story time about this trip about a month and a half later. We did this shit mid-summer. It is now October. Sorry about that, Abdul, Nugs, Braun, and... I mean, Nick, I know it's been mad long. I fucked up. I'm sorry. One of the gifts of being such a large man is that it's very rare where I feel genuine fear and genuinely vulnerable. When you're buried alive from the chest down, I cannot describe the feeling of vulnerability I felt right there. It was terrible. I never want to feel like that again. Mission successful. A big brother can fit in the hole. And now... it's time for the club. Now, at this club, I didn't really record much of anything, okay? I didn't really want to bring the camera, you know, I was kind of... I'm not a big partier, ladies and gentlemen, believe it or not. You know, I know it's crazy, you must think I go to all the parties. I haven't been to a singular party in my life, besides this one. So, I've never been like this. I'm not a big dancer. I don't like to dance, I don't like to sing, I ain't into all that. So when I went to this, I was very out of place, okay? I didn't bring the camera because when I'm out of place, I'm uncomfortable. And when I'm uncomfortable, I won't produce good content for you. And it's a waste of my time and energy. So I'm just not going to do it. I need to get comfortable. But I will say I recorded a little bit on my telephone. Nugget was getting butt. It was crazy. It was nuts. When we get to the club, 21 and under, right? So it's only like, it's like losers, high schoolers, and like horny 20-year-olds, right? So the crew is not that bad. So I get in, I'm sitting there, there's really nothing going on. The club's empty. It's me, Abs, Nick, Nugs, and Braun, right? There's nothing's going on. So Abdul and I, we left. You know, there's nothing going on. We left. We went out, went and did our own shit, just left. Came back like an hour later, it was bumping, right? We get back in there. Abdul starts trying to get stupid in there, but nobody else with us is trying to get dumb. You know, Nugget says he's a partier, he's an animal. He's not. Nugs, I love you, but you're a fucking liar. You ain't no party animal, you're a fraud. Alright? You say all this shit, it's the wrong group. Brother, you say you're a partier, you're supposed to be a fucking partier. Nugget was standing in there, Abdul was trying to get lit. No one's getting lit with Abdul. I'm not getting lit with Abdul. I don't get lit. I'm not that kind of guy. Nugget was supposed to. He ain't doing it. So Abdul was pissed. You know, rightfully so. I would have been pretty pissed if I was a partier too. So Abdul and I leave again. We come back like another 30 minutes later. It's really bumping this time. Nugget's dancing. Nick's dancing. Braun's just standing there awkwardly like Braun does. But Braun's kind of dancing. I don't dance. I just stood there with my guys. Abdul was in there going dumb. Abdul was getting a little bit of butt in there. But you know who got the most butt? Let me tell y'all. It was Nugget. Roll that fucking clip. Please roll that clip. As y'all could imagine, we got pretty turned up in that club that night. But you know, not me. I just like to stand there and observe. I'm that guy. I like to stand in the back and observe. But let me tell y'all what I observed. So, as I'm observing, the setup of this club, right, it's like DJ at the front, dance floor in the center, right, and then on the top, there's like two shelves here almost of two people that you can dance, shake ass up here, and there's a top bunk, right, top bunk's where all the animals go, semi-animals, and the twerps, pretty much how it's set up. I'm sitting in the back of the twerp section, observing everything. Oh, and there's a cage where all the skanks go and shake butt, I swear to God. So at this, I was sitting at the back of the twerp section, right, I can view the semi-animal section pretty well. As I'm viewing it, I see a bunch of these crackheads giving ass to these thugs, right? And they were going dumb. The bitch, they started literally like fucking. In the semi-animal thing, they were dead ass going in the semi-animal, and I couldn't believe it. They started making out. Oh my God, the DJ stopped, put a light on him so the whole crew could see. It was nuts. So after all that happens, I rotate towards the front of the twerp section, which is where like the cages are at. And the cages, right? There's always skanks in there shaking butt. And the one skank that was shaking butt in there happens to be, let me not call her a skank. The girl. Nugga starts waving at the girl to come over. And the girl, she comes over and she starts shaking butt on Nugget, right? Nugget's going down and getting the butt like he does. And then he points to me, starts telling her, yeah, come over here, shake it over. I said, no, I don't want that. I don't do that. I'm not a dog. So I didn't take it. I respectfully declined. But Nugget went upstairs with her, got some more butt for like 30 minutes. Came back down, and that was pretty much the end of the night. Left, went home, ate some good food, left in the morning, and that's all she wrote. Good to go. Thank y'all for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe, and have a beautiful night. I love y'all so much. Pass the dutchie pan the left hand side.